Yo, Rayman, you queued up, man. What's the deal?
Oh shit, what's happening, Nico?
What's going on, sir?
Hey man, I'm chilling here with my little brother, man, watching ESPN
Okay,
and
I heard that. I heard that.
shit. Yeah, just chilling on the day off.
I hope you haven't indoctrinated him to start wearing side knots too, man.
Oh yeah, my little brother, his ways are actually better than mine, man. His ways are better than mine. He that nigga wear like two or three durags at a time. I can't keep up. That nigga.
Like you said,
He be
two or three
wild.
at a time. God damn.
He's dead ass. The nigga has the stocking caps, so it's like not the ones that you tie, but he got like this the ones you put on. Then he put on one, and it's like a regular durag. Then he put on the silk jump. That's the trick. You gotta put
This
on the
nigga over
silk
here trying to
durag.
give his do-rag waves, man. I'm done.
Just trying to give you a durag away. So quiet. Oh shit.
What's good though, man?
Hey man, I'm chilling, Nico, man. You already know what it is. I'm writing for the next Shots Fired event, August 25th in Dago, man, Vista, California. We going out to Max Taylor's neck of the woods, man. Gonna be good.
Okay,
Payphil
okay,
actually
okay. Have they announced
dropped
your
the
opponent yet, or is it?
They have not announced my opponent yet. Payphil dropped the performances. There's gonna be live performances. You know, my boy Amon, the MC, I believe, my boy Knox is performing. You know, so that flyer's out. You can check it out on the Shots Fired Battle League Facebook page, and you know, follow us on Twitter at Shots Fired Rap. I'm the one that runs the Shots Fired Twitter, so you know, y'all can get at us on Twitter, man. I'm running it, so I'll definitely respond. You know, fuck with people.
I heard that. Heard that. So, man, what's been going on, man? You just had a recent battle drop versus Dot Everything. You know what I'm saying? Dope little
Facts,
back and forth battle, man. How you feeling about it?
Oh man, I'm really happy. You know, I don't know. I know you're the one. You have, you know, extensive knowledge of this shit. I'm not sure. Maybe you know. I believe it's the first draft battle to get dropped on the main page. I'm not sure if other
That
ones
is a
have,
fact. That is a fact.
but you know, and it's really, you know, it was a big thing for me. You know, because that's what I wanted. I wanted to get a main page drop. So when it dropped on the draft page, I was like, oh damn. But then, you know, when the battle went down, you know, I called Ron. I asked Ron what was going on. He was actually confused about it too. And then that was when KP texted me. He was like, nah, y'all are getting on the main page. So, you know, battle got taken down, put back up. And it says draft, but it's on the main page. You feel me? So I'm okay with that. Especially because I like the way the draft battles are edited. You know, it's all in gray. And then somebody says something fire, and then the color comes in. I think that editing is dope. Shout out to Ron for that.
There, yeah, fire, fire, fire.
Yeah. Shout out
Yeah,
to
man. I
Dot
mean,
too, man.
do you do?
I was listening to your interview with Dot yesterday, and I really wish I would have heard that interview before I battled Dot. He said a lot of things. He said a lot of things that I felt like could have been beneficial to me writing for him. Because, you know, Dot, he's a very stoic individual. You don't get a lot from Dot. So, an interview where he's actually opening up and saying things, you know, you can really get an insight of how his head and how his brain works, you know. And shout out to you for, like, you know, being able to pull something like that off with him. But I'm definitely hyped for what he does with King Leo.
Oh
This
yeah, no, it's
tournament's going
gonna
to be
be
fire.
interesting, man, at the tournament. Yeah,
Oh yeah,
facts.
that tournament's crazy. Niggas is pushing their narratives, man. I was at work yesterday, so I wasn't able to tap in with like your live or Profane's live about the whole deal. You know, I'm kind of siding with y'all. You feel me? I don't see why everybody else is getting upset about the tournament when it's random, and then people are like, oh, it's rigged. But I don't get that, because how would it be rigged when everybody wants their league to win? So you're telling me that every league agreed that they was gonna give KO an edge, or give Profane an edge, or give Sabanic an edge? Like, I don't believe that. That doesn't, that makes zero sense to me, because every league wants to win. It's magnitude. Like, come on now, that doesn't make no sense at all. You pick the names out the hat, and you know, you keep moving. But that's just how I see things.
I heard that. No, I definitely understand where you're coming from on that one, man. I know that you actually are on Team Shots Fired, man. So how do you feel about your five-man team? You know what I'm saying? How do you feel about your upcoming battle? You know what I'm saying? Talk to me.
And I feel like we have the potential to sweep. I feel like we are one of the teams who we have a solid roster, you feel me? We have a nice mixture of young dudes and, you know, solidified guys, people like YD and Knox Overstreet. You know what you get from them. Of course, myself and my ghost game, bro, Young Soto, and my nigga Sab in the tournament. Now, Sab, you know, he made it pretty deep in the tournament last year. You know, him, Accolade, and Spot had their little Battle Royale joint, you know. So I'm sure Sab is, you know, going to come back, and he's going to push his narratives, you know, to try to get through and win that money, you know, and battle Spot again and get his get back. And, you know, Soto, he's been, you know, his last battle against Accolade, he really showed, you know, what he has, and he's been trying to improve. And, you know, that's my bro, so I'm going to be on his line all the time about it. You know, myself, me, honestly, like, I'm just thankful for the opportunity. I see a lot of people complaining about, you know, the matchups they get and the battles they get. And I'm like, bro, it's magnitude at the end of the day. You know, every league is going to be out here. You know, league reps is going to be out here. People are going to be watching. So it ain't really who you're standing in front of, you know. You can impress people and not be standing in front of anything. You know, like me, my first two battles, I was able to impress people. Even though, you know, CSIN isn't a big name or Select isn't a big name, I was still able to create a small buzz based on those battles. So, you know, with the look, you can do anything. It really all depends on how much you are motivated for it and how much work you want to put into it. It's like when my nigga Brad was on the line last night and we were talking about how we both battled Select, and you know, it was a debatable on his end, and I clearly beat Select, and he was like, "Well, you tried your hardest," and that statement really baffled me, you know, like, oh, it's not cool to try hard anymore, like. I don't get it. We in here to be mediocre. That's something I never understand. You feel me? With each his own, I know what I'm trying to do in battle rap. I know how I'm trying to get ahead, how I'm trying to, you know, help not only myself but the West, you know, get pushed forward and, you know, new talent and all that good stuff, you know. But I guess that's just me, man. Not everybody looks at it the same.
All right, that's, let me ask you a question, man. Let me ask this, because a lot of people, there's a lot of confusion out here, especially in this 2018 year, man. We done had about five or six new crews start up, man, and y'all being one of them, the Ghost Gang, Casper Squad, all those good things.
Yeah.
How did y'all come up with the concept of calling it Ghost Gang? Like, how did y'all start, and where are y'all trying to take Ghost Gang to? Is it just for battle rap, or is it more than that?
So, Soto was actually the originator, you know, and Soto, at first it was just him and Trav, you know, and so I actually met Soto before I started battling. I met Soto late last year at a Shots Fired event, and you know, you know how Soto is, you know how I am, so naturally when we first met, there was a lot of shit talking, you know, and then when we actually sat down, you know, we got to the nitty gritty of it. We seen what we could do together, you know, especially being the only two rookies in Shots Fired, you know. The way we see things is we can really team up and take everything over, you know. Me and Soto, starting out with just us two, we had a nice dynamic, a nice yin and yang, you know. He was the bad guy. Don't nobody really like Soto because all that shit he talks and, you know, all the heckling and all the trolling he does, and, you know, me, I'm more likable than he is, you know, so it was a good balance. And then, you know, so we decided we were going to, you know, build on that balance and really just try to help each other out and look out for each other, you know. Me and Soto, we're friends in real life, you know. We might have met at an event, but that's really my nigga, you know. I go out to where he at out there in Lincoln Park all the time, you know, just to fuck with him, you know, just to see what he on, just to see what my nigga Trav on, you know, just to tap in. Because Dago, even though I'm not from out here, you know, the city ain't showing me nothing but love, especially, you know, out there in the hood, in the southeast, and in Canto, you know, Smurf P, all those niggas, man, they done all really showed me love and embraced me. So, you know, I can't help but show the love back to the city. And as far as my nigga Lucky, you feel me, he's seen, you know, the dynamic between me and Soto and how with his shit talking and, you know, my promotion and all that other shit, how we were, you know, being talked about. And he really liked the way we was moving, you know. We felt like him being out there in Fresno and on PNR, you know, that's a whole nother avenue that could open up. And, you know, we fuck with Lucky, you know. He's very talented. He brings a different energy. He has a, you know, great confidence. And we felt like he fit in, you know, with the scheme of things and what we were trying to do. And so, you know, it kind of just fit. Me, him, and Soto, we talk every day. We chop it up. We spar. We keep each other sharp, you know. Those are really my niggas.
Heard that. So I got to ask the question, man. I want you to be as honest as possible with this answer, sir.
Yes. I got you. Okay.
Is Ghost Gang the best crew in battle rap? And if so, why? What makes y'all the best?
Honestly, so do you mean like a grassroots standpoint, or are you talking about, you know,
all grassroots, all of, you know what I'm saying? I'll even keep it to just this year. Like, you got your Banger Squad, you got the Society, Ghost Gang, you know, you got some of these crews out here, yep. Dubs, you know. Is Ghost Gang the best, though?
I feel like we are, man. Keep the G real with you. You know why? Because I feel like every other crew, they have their specific members that have things going for them, right? But there are some members that aren't, you know, really, really as, really on the same level, you feel me? I feel like myself, Soto, and Lucky, we all going out there, we improving, we doing we supposed to, you know, every battle, really trying to come out there and do our thing, as opposed to, say, somebody like the Banger Squad, right? They best member by a long shot is Red Bangs. You know, Red Bangs is definitely 100% the best in that crew. You know, and we don't really have somebody that sort of kind of carries
no them. Love for Rubber Ducky Russ.
It's not that I don't fuck with Russ. You know, Russ is my boy, but Red Bangs is amazing, bro. I know that.
She is fine.
Red Bangs.
That is a fact.
Red Bangs is different. I feel like Russ brings a different dynamic to their crew. That's what I'll say about Russ. Russ, although he may lack bars, he makes up for it in his presentation, his showmanship, and his entertainment value and what he does for the crowd. And Russ has a following. You know, he's a very hard worker. He does shit that I thought people were done trying to sell CDs at gas stations, but no, you see Russ every day on Instagram taking pictures with new people, getting followers, really out there doing their thing. So I most definitely fuck with Russ. But I'm just talking about from a pure talent standpoint. And as a society, you know, I see the moves they're making, you know, what they think they got going on in October, and I commend them on.
Alright, my apologies for the technical difficulties. Y'all probably wondering why I got so goddamn quiet, why ain't nobody was talking shit. It's because this nigga Raymay keep using these damn old-ass Nokia Metro PCSs, man, from East Oakland, man. That's what it is, man. But continue your story, sir.
Hey, man, listen. The bones you get from East Oakland, man, they'll hold you down for a good week and a half. That's all I gotta say. But nah, so yeah, back to the topic of why I believe that we're best. I feel like not only talent wise, but I feel like potential wise and just the dynamic of our group, we really have the potential to really, you know, solidify ourselves in the West and really make a push in battle rap. You know, no knock to the Society and, you know, the Banger Squad and all those niggas. You know, I just feel like personally, we have more going for us.
I heard that. So I gotta ask you this question, man. I gotta ask this question. Word on the street, and this is not Nico's word, by the way, but word on the street is that Ray May out here turducking Mr. Willie G, man. What's the story with this Willie G battle, man? Are we ever gonna see it go down, man? What's the deal, man?
Well, okay, so the Willie G battle, man. Shout out to my nigga Willie G, right? I fuck with Willie G on a personal level. You feel me? I don't believe he should be taking roids. You feel me? I don't, you know, putting a needle in your ass is not the same.
Hey, yo, hold on. Allegedly.
Anyway, putting needles in your ass is not something Willie should be doing. But you feel me? honestly, so here's my thing with Willie G, right? In February, I remember me and Willie, honestly, we've been going back and forth. We were arguing on your show, Nico. It felt like every night me and Willie was having these big ass arguments that took up big ass chunks of the show. You feel me? And I told him, I was like, listen, bro, we can really battle right now, right? Then, you know, he was hitting me with the oh. I'm booked up right now. Da 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 da. I don't, you know, I'm not trying to do it right now. So then, after a while, bro, you know what? Fuck it. I done tried everything. You feel me? I done tried switching opponents on cars. I done tried coming out to his league. I done tried doing, you know, everything to get a battle with Willie Kraken. But you know, it just didn't seem like it was gonna happen. So you know, once I realized that it wasn't gonna happen, I decided, you know, look ahead, like. I can really give a fuck about battling Willie now. You know, it's like I just battled Dot, who I feel like is better than Willie. And, you know, my opponent on the Shots Fire car, I feel like he's better than Willie. My opponent for Magnitude is a vet. He's been around for a while. You feel me? I feel like it's a good look. And then in October, I have my nigga KO out there in Vegas. It's going to be my first out-of-state joint. So, you know, honestly, when people bring up the Willie battle to me now, I'm like, bro, honestly, I'm booked up now. You feel me? What am I gonna do? You know, and I understand that Willie had a bunch of battles that didn't really go down. But it's like if you look at the names we had lined up, you know, it's not the same. He had Primo and Dot. I just battled Dot. You feel me? And you know him and Dot didn't go down. Him and Primo didn't go down. And you know for whatever reason, you know I don't really know those niggas like that. You know. I fucks with Dot, but I don't know what reason he had to not come. And but me, you know, I'm just looking at it like, okay, bro, you wasn't trying to see me, right? We could have easily fit it in on any of these battles that you've been booking with other people. We could easily had it go down, but you did. And I know for a fact leagues have asked him. So if he can't not want to do it, and then look at me like, why don't you want to do it now? Like, why didn't you want to do it back then when we first started, when people actually really wanted to see me and Willie, you know? We was arguing all the time, trolling each other on Facebook. You know, that shot that I took at Willie in the Dot battle is really the last thing you'll hear from me about Willie. At least for now.
So, hold on. Let me get this straight. You taking shots in battles, but we ain't going to see the battle?
So here's the funny thing about the shot. I wrote the shot for Willie, like to battle Willie. And then when I realized it wasn't going to happen, I was like, I kind of still want to say this because it's funny. And I'm glad I did because everyone laughed. Because that shit was funny, Nico. And you laughed too. You know that shit was funny, Nico. That shit was fucking comedy.
Listen, man, Nico is a neutral party in this. I didn't laugh. I don't know the bar.
This nigga Nico pretending like he didn't laugh, like everyone else in the room.
Hey, look, man. I wasn't on. Listen, man, there's Listen, man, there's no evidence of such. You don't even see Nico on camera, man. I don't know. Willie G, I don't know what he's talking about right now, man.
And listen, you want to – Willie wants to push this narrative that I'm ducking him. How about the fact he's ducking Lucky? My ghost gang, nigga. No one talks about that.
Okay, can we – Can we be real? Is it ducking if you say something on the radio and then the next day the battle ain't happening? Now it's ducking?
Hey, listen.
How is it ducking?
Willie said,
how is it ducking?
Willie,
I just want to know, how is it ducking?
Listen, Willie said they can line it up after whatever date it was they said on the phone. Lucky started hitting up league owners and was like, look, we can lock it in after Magnitude. Neither of us have battles after Magnitude. We can lock it in. And he didn't want to do it. I feel like you can't, like, it's the same thing he did with me. He argued on the phone and didn't want a battle. You can't, like, it's comedy, though. It really is. It's funny.
Listen, man. According to your ghost gang partner, man, everybody ducking him, man. But if you think Willie G ducking him, man,
okay,
Willie G, man.
You hearing me right now, man.
The media is telling you, if you do not battle Lucky Desperado, you will be known as the duck. Not the rubber ducky rust kind of duck, but turd ducking.
Yeah, duck.
You don't want to be turd ducking out here.
Listen, like, and you see, honestly, that's honestly like where the dynamic in the group really is good. You feel me? And there might be some battles that I might not be willing to take, but you know who is willing to take them? My nigga Lucky. He'll battle anybody. He'll battle a little tank top on the street. He doesn't care. Lucky could give two fucks. He's trying to rap. That's why I fuck with Lucky. He don't care who you are. You could ask Lucky to battle Twerk next week. He'll be like, shit, let's do it. Not afraid. He ain't afraid of shit. That's my boy. That's why if anybody ever pushes a narrative that Lucky's ducking them, that's when you should not believe.
Oh, it's true. Oh, he's definitely ducking. No, he's definitely ducking. We ain't going to say who he's ducking, but he's ducking.
Who's Lucky ducking?
He, Ray May, Lucky Desperado is ducking. What the gun do? That's what he's ducking.
Oh,
that's what he's ducking out here in these streets. He's ducking what the gun do. That's what he's ducking.
He wants to battle you. That's the issue, though, Nico. He's not. He wants
listen,
to battle
man,
you.
That's what they all listen, man. That's what they all say, man. But every time a league owner hits somebody up on my behalf, like, hey, we want to battle Nico, crickets, I tell you.
Hey, listen, a league has never hit my line talking about Nico, so you're not talking about me right there.
Listen, man, you already know why they ain't hit my line. Because, listen, a league knows better than to hit my line about Ray May, man, because they know what's going to happen, man. It's going to be a whole bunch of NorCal narratives getting thrown, and I think you too removed from NorCal to respond to them, man. So, you know.
You'll probably just try to shit on Fairfield like all Sacramento niggas do. I don't know why y'all hate us. You feel me? We ain't never did shit.
I'm going to be honest. I'm going to be real. I wouldn't shit on the city, but I would. I ain't gonna say that because we might actually end up fucking around having like a little fun, little friendly fade one day. So I'm not gonna say that. But I wouldn't be shitting on the city. I wouldn't shit on the city, man. I fuck with the Bay Area. I fuck with Fairfield, man. They always showed me love when I went out there.
Fuck, man. You already know it is, nigga. Nigga, you see some crazy shit out there. I love that place, man. I'm trying to plan a trip back home with my mama, man. She's talking about going to go see my auntie, so we finna head out there soon. You know, I told her I really feel like when I'm out there, depending on how long I'm out there, man, I might head out to Sac for a day. You know, fuck with you, my boy Drix. Maybe next, you know, go out there see my niggas right quick. You know, I gotta show love. Since you niggas swear I'm a SoCal nigga now, man. I don't know, we've been out here for a few years, but I guess I'm a SoCal nigga now.
Heard that. I'm sorry, man. We just had a ghost. Another ghost just took over my radio show. Lucky, are you on the phone, sir?
Yes, sir. go. Ain't nobody ducking you, nigga.
Hey, look. We done talked about Willie G. We done talked about if Ghost Gang is the number one crew. We done talked about NorCal narrative. We done talked about a whole bunch of shit. The only thing this nigga Lucky wants to pinpoint is what the gun do. That's the only thing he cares about. He's obsessed with what the gun do.
If I'm obsessed, how am I ducking? I can't be obsessed and ducking in the same sentence. Like, it's just not. It's not a thing.
Yeah, that narrative makes no sense.
I didn't think it was a
Nico,
thing either, bro. Until it happened.
Nico, did I tell you, Nico? We breaking the industry, bro. So I was sitting there. I was cleaning up. You feel me? And me, when I clean up around the house, you know, I play music and I kind of just let the music run. And so there's this song on Drake's album. I didn't really listen to it because, you know, a lot of the R&B shit he was kicking on that most recent album, I wasn't really fucking with. But the shit was on shuffle. I was just letting the songs play. This nigga was talking about narratives and his song was Ty Dolla $ign. And I'm like, Ty Dolla $ign is a West Coast artist. He talking about narratives. West Coast now media.
Oh, the narratives is everywhere, man.
You breaking the industry, Nico. You breaking the industry. I see Jay Black talking about narratives all the time.
Man, look, man, one narrative at a time, man.
Hey, man, listen.
I know, that's a fact.
Like I said,
that's a fact, man. But let me ask you this, man, because this is your rookie year. You know what I'm saying? You ain't even been battling, what, 6 months at this point right now?
Yeah, my debut was February 24th, Belly of the Beast 4 against you.
So what have you, in the three battles that you've had in this time that you've been around battle rap, what's something that you've learned that's helped you, and what's something that you've learned that you're like, man, that didn't really help at all? Like, what have you seen so far in your early career?
So what I noticed, because do you mean from like an in the ring standpoint or out of the ring standpoint?
Oh, both. Either one.
Okay, so as far as in the ring, what I realized, well, with me, my biggest issue is my cadence, you know. And so I spent every battle, you know, trying to kick a different cadence, you know, hoping that, you know, it'll really work out for me or something. I've been talking to my nigga Grizz and, you know, even my nigga Diesel about setups, and, you know, how important setups are in battle rap. You know, me, I'm a puncher. Lucky is a puncher. Soto is a puncher. And so when you're a puncher, I feel like setups are really key, right? How you set up a punch. You can throw a punch, but if the punch comes out of nowhere, it's not going to land. It's just like in boxing, you know. You can swing, but if you don't, like, you know, if you barely hit the nigga, it's all right, you know. But if you set your feet up right, you know, you square up and you hit that nigga dead in his face, it's over, you know. So it's all about making your punches connect through the setups, you know. It's all of that, you know. And I didn't understand that at first. I thought, you know, punching was really all that mattered. That's why if you see my battle with C-San, all I'm really doing is punching. You know, and so I'm really just trying to learn how to set up my punches better and also do other things besides punch, you know. And then from an out-of-the-ring standpoint, I've learned that battle rap is very different from what I thought it was growing up, right? I always thought battle rap was this game of nothing but real niggas who was always on real nigga time doing real nigga shit, you know. And the more and more that I get into this game, I know that people are, they do weird shit, they hate on you low-key, you know, they talk shit about you low-key, but then they'll smile to your face, you know. So really, what I've learned and what I've, you know, started to understand is that you can't fuck with everybody. That's definitely something that I've learned. You know, when I first came in, I really tried to show love to everybody, but you can't really show love to everybody, man, because not everybody's going to fuck with you the same way, you know? And you never know who really got, you know, the knife chilling, waiting to stab you behind your back, you know? And the shit is really crazy, man.
Okay. I heard that. Well, shit, man, we done talk this shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Before we get up out of here, man, go ahead and first and foremost, appreciate you calling up, man, taking some time out of the day.
Oh, yeah.
Talk this shit real quick.
Yeah, And then I've been, you know, you
go ahead
hit me up to do the interview, you know, a while back, and I've been trying to get back at you, you know, nigga. I've been trying to get my my personal life situated, you know, trying to get my job today, you know, my shit together, you know, try to make some money so I can invest. We got some Ghost Gang shit coming to y'all soon, man. Me and Lucky and Soto, we working on logos, man. Bring y'all some shit. Me, myself, I done finalized a couple logos, man. We just got to get them paid for and, you know, get everything moving. So we got some merch coming soon. Like I said, follow Shots Fire Rap on Twitter. You feel me? If you add us, if you mention us, it's me and K Philosophy behind the account. So, you know, one of us will respond to you. You can follow me at Twitter and Instagram at Young Ray May, and Young is spelled correctly for you old illiterate ass niggas. You feel me? You know how some niggas they prefer grammar over spelling. Me, I need everything to be spelled correctly.
Hey, inside joke, man. Y'all gonna have to watch the show to peek what he's talking about, man. Good grief.
Check the place out, man. West Coast Battle Media shit. Vista, California, August 25th, man. I will be battling. My boy Young Soto will be battling. We're gonna have live performances out here in Dago from people like Amon, EMC, and Knox Overstreet. Magnitude, September 24th. The whole Ghost Gang is on Magnitude. A lot of, you know, none of the other crews can say that. You feel me? Not any of the new crews, at least, you know, can't say that they whole squad is on Magnitude. We're all on Magnitude, and none of us are in the fifth spot on the tournament. So I feel like that definitely means something. And then, you know, last but not least, you know, shout out my nigga Lil KO, 13th at the J. Scott event in Vegas. Myself versus Lil KO will be going down, man. And watch Ray May versus Dot Everything on the riot.
I heard that. Well, salutes calling up, man.